to change our lives forever. Building our nations and our homes, restoring sight to the blind, bringing hope to the hopeless. It goes beyond language barrier, 'cause it's a God carrier. It's our messenger angel to the rest of the world. It's Rhapsody. Our reality is giving our lives a meaning. Rhapsody. Our reality is giving our day a lift. Directing our path and lightening our world. Rhapsody of reality. It has come to change our lives forever. Just for me now.
Every day in different nations of the world, the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ is contained in Rhapsody of Realities is impacting lives, and millions are having their lives shaped by God's Word. Join us this month as we bring you yet another insightful study of the November edition of your favorite devotional, all the way from South Korea, Southeast Asia.
안녕하세요.
It's new.
Of functioning, not by what you see or what you feel, but functioning and acting upon faith in God's Word.
It's different.
God wants us to be exactly like Jesus.
And we're so honored to be sharing the month of November's Rhapsody of Realities with you.
Stay tuned. Today's Nuggets from Rhapsody of Realities.
Annyeonghaseyo, banggassseumnida.
Hello, welcome to Rhapsody of Realities. We're reaching all the way from South Korea, Seoul, South Korea. My name is Paula Kim.
And I'm Sunmi.
And we're just so excited to share the Rhapsody of Realities with you today. Right now we're sharing on the November edition, and we have so many great things in store for the month of November. Don't forget, at the International Pastors and Partners Conference is taking place in November in Nigeria, Lagos, with Pastor Chris, and that's going to be a great, amazing convergence of all the people in ministry who are living for the gospel and bearing fruit and spreading the life of God, the Zoe life of God, all around the world. So be excited about that and get involved with that. Today's message is by Pastor Anita, and the title is Ordained to a Fruitful Life. Let's read the opening verse together. If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy. For a temple of God is holy, which temple ye are. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Here it says that you are the temple of God, that you are the temple of God, which is holy, made righteous, separated for God's use. And we'll share more about this after we come back after our short break.
It goes beyond language barrier, 'cause it's a God carrier. It's our messenger angel to the rest of the world. It's Rhapsody. Our reality is giving our lives a meaning.
Life is beautiful. Life is exciting. Life is an adventure. Life is a song. Life is a story. Life is a gift, and you can live it to the full as Rhapsody of Realities guides you through life.
Rhapsody of Realities has just been a true inspiration. When I started reading it, I couldn't stop each day. My life got more structured.
Start placing your orders now. Call the numbers showing on your screen or visit our website, www.rhapsodyofrealities.org. Rhapsody of Realities, giving your day a lift.
Welcome back. Today, the message titled Ordained to a Fruitful Life, meaning your life and our life. are ordained to a fruitful life.
Amen.
Fruitful life.
Fruitful.
You know, we have to produce fruits from God, fruits of God through us and in our lives.
Amen.
And people can see the fruits and they can notice something different.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
So let's get into the main message. The Greek word rendered defile in the verse above primarily means to waste, to render inactive, ineffective, or inoperative. If any man renders the temple of God useless or inactive, such that it is not functioning with respect to the purpose for which it was made. The Bible says, him shall God destroy. That means God shall pluck him up. You have to read from the beginning of the chapter to see the context of discussion.
The word defile does not mean to make dirty, but actually means to waste, or to make inactive, or ineffective, or inoperative. That means that the temple of God, you are the temple of God, we are God's temple. God dwells in us, his presence is in us, and we have a designed function. But when you don't function the way God designed for us to function, then you're rendered inactive and useless. And you're not being used the way that God has designed for us to function. And that is defiling the temple of God. So here it said that God does not allow that. God will destroy the one that renders the temple of God useless or inactive. So remember, we have to be functioning the way God wants us to function. Now, how does God want us to function? Let's find out in the next paragraph together. No wonder the Lord said in John chapter 15, verses 1 to 2, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away.
He taketh away.
Amen.
Why is that?
Why would he take it away?
Yeah.
Well, if the branch is connected to the vine, and the branch is not producing fruit, then that fruit, that branch is being useless, and it's not functioning. The branch is designed to be fruitful.
Yeah.
It's not being fruitful. It's really useless, and it's a waste.
Yeah, and also, the branch which does not produce the fruits, ripe fruits, actually defile other branches by wasting the nutrients that other branches can use for their growth. So God is not a God of waste, and we ought not to be the children of waste. So we ought not to waste anything, but actually produce the right fruits all the time.
Amen. And everything God creates and designs has a purpose.
And
that's why it's never wasteful. It has a certain function. It always produces a certain kind of fruit. Let's keep reading. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purgeth it, that it may bring forth more fruit.
Amen. Another purpose of purging. You know, God purges it that it may bring forth more fruit.
More
fruit.
He always wants more.
Not the same level always, but we can increase the fruit every day, day by day, to produce more and more fruit.
Amen. Who takes the unfruitful vine away? It's God. Every branch in the vine that is unfruitful is taken away, but every branch that bears fruit is purged and pruned to bear more fruit. John 15, verse 2.
Amen.
The Lord Jesus is the vine, and we are his branches. That means you're connected to the Lord, and therefore predestined and ordained to a fruitful life.
Hallelujah.
We were designed. God has destined us to be fruitful in this life. Why? Because we are his branches connected to him.
Amen.
If the branch is connected to the vine, every nutrient from the vine, every good thing that flows from the vine that makes the vine grow is sent directly to the branches. So all the branch has to do is stay connected. Amen.
Amen. So the life that the vine has is the same life that we have. As we are his branches.
Amen.
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 Exactly the same life.
Amen.
Same quality.
Yes.
That's what we have.
Yes.
The life of God. The life of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Amen.
It's God's desire that you're increasingly fruitful and productive at every stage of your life. Mm. I love this because he says he doesn't want us to be fruitful, let's bear 10 fruits today, 10 fruits tomorrow, 10 fruits next day, but he wants us to bear 10 for today, 50 tomorrow, 100 the next day,
Amen.
500, 10,000. He wants us to keep increasing.
Increasingly fruitful.
That
Amen.
Is God is designed for it. There is no limit to how productive God wants us to be.
Yes. Amen. That's desire. That is God's desire.
Amen.
You know, I even thought of this.
Mm-hmm.
What if a man or a woman, like your close friend, sincerely saying, you know what, I really want you to be happy.
Mm-hmm.
I really want you to be happy.
Mm-hmm.
That's really touching.
Yes.
But you know, God just didn't stop there. There's a hoping and wishing
mm-hmm.
that, okay, I want them to be happy
mm-hmm.
in their lives.
Mm-hmm.
No, God just didn't stop there. No. He provided everything that
Amen.
we need for us to be happy and enjoy the life.
Amen.
To enjoy the life.
Exactly.
And God predestined
mm-hmm.
our future.
Mm-hmm.
He did everything.
Mm-hmm.
He already laid out
yes.
the way that
destiny
we ought to follow.
Yes. Amen. All we have to do is walk into it.
Exactly.
That destiny is found in God's word.
Exactly.
Amen.
Amen.
It's found out the secret of how we can do that.
Mm-hmm.
The secret is a very big secret. The secret is remaining connected to the Lord. Amen. You have to stay connected as a branch to the vine.
Amen.
Let's keep reading. He said in John chapter 15, verse 5, he that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, ye can do nothing. Amen.
For without me, ye can do nothing.
Amen.
In other words, with me, you can do all things.
Everything.
But
what you have to do, you have to abide in me. You have to live in the Lord. You have to live with the Word and live in the Word always.
Yes,
that's
we can do all things through Christ, which strengthens us.
Amen.
So we can do everything. We can do everything.
Everything. All things.
Mm-hmm.
When you're connected with Him, living with Him, He will allow you, He provides you with the strength
mm-hmm.
and all the things you need to live a fruitful life.
Exactly.
If you want to be fruitful and productive, bringing forth fruits in increasing measure, stay connected to the vine.
Amen. This mm-hmm. is what we need to do.
Amen.
Stay connected to the vine.
Mm-hmm.
Stay connected to the vine.
Mm-hmm.
Why? If you want to bring forth fruits,
mm-hmm.
that's the purpose.
Mm-hmm.
Then this is the answer.
Amen.
Stay connected to the vine.
Amen. So if you're unfruitful, that's a sign that you're not connected.
Yeah, exactly.
You're not properly connected to
uh-huh,
the vine, which
uh-huh.
means the vine really is Christ, and Christ is His Word. So when you're connected to God's Word, you're properly connected and you're bound to be fruitful. So check yourself. If you're not being fruitful, are you connected
uh-huh.
to God's Word?
Amen. Would you like to take a short break right now?
Of course, right now.
Yeah. So we're going to take a short break and we will be right back.